Praise God, brothers and sisters. Blessed be the name of our Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach. Say this, I laugh to myself when I would state a doctrine. I've stated several doctrines that are standard across lots of denominations, and then someone will say, oh, this guy's a false prophet because he said that, that speaking in tongues is for today, as an example, or whatever. When there's, you know, like, whatever it may be, there's 200 or 300 million people in the world who are Pentecostals. You know, and there's thousands or hundreds of thousands of pastors who have this doctrine. So you can say that all these people are wrong, not, oh, like I'd invented a new doctrine. That's what's so silly. These people are so ignorant, they don't even know what the denominations believe. They don't even know that millions and millions of people have been baptized in the Holy Spirit with speaking in tongues. They think it's just like, oh, a few nuts, false prophets, when it's millions of people. Millions and millions of people around the world. As a matter of fact, the only denominations growing in the world is Pentecostal denominations. Fastest growing is Assemblies of God. But as a matter of fact, does that mean that it's perfect? No. But that's where God's moving in the Spirit-filled people. Those other old denominations are going down. Go into any evangelical denominational church, and it's just all a bunch of old, it's all gray-headed people in there. You know, and they're just repeating to themselves, as I said in this video, the last one. They're up there repeating, I'm glad I got saved. As a matter of fact, the last church, when I preached in the denominational church in North Carolina, that's what the, when I got there, the before the pastor introduced me, got up there and talked about, gave his testimony about when he got saved 60 years ago and where he was, and praise God, I'm got saved. And everybody said, praise God, when they got saved, and that's it. Nothing beyond that. To be born again, a babe, a brand new babe in Christ for 50 years. Still a babe. I still, you know. Okay, but when you got saved, you're born again. Okay, when you're born, what do? Learn to eat. Learn to feed yourself. Learn to walk. Learn to talk. Learn to go to the bathroom. Learn to read and write. You know, you got to grow up. Move on beyond the sincere milk of the word. On to the meat. Hebrews chapter 6. Brothers and sisters, I want to say this too, because I'm on a roll. This is a long video. Excuse me. You do not have to speak in tongues to be raptured. You do not have to be baptized in the Holy Spirit with evidence of speaking in tongues and being raptured, to be raptured. You must be born again. When you're born again by grace through faith, then you are a child of God. And I say this all the time. I want to say it again. If you're truly born again and you love the Lord, you want all that God's got for you. So many of you have been taught the false doctrine that the power of the gifts of the Spirit are not for today. They call it cessationalism. You know, cessation. They believe that it stopped when the Bible was finished being written. And they use a text, the same text they use to say when people will know you in heaven. I've heard 100 Baptist preachers say, because I've been to lots of funerals as a pastor, and I preach. Sometimes there's a Baptist, you know, another preacher that would also preach. And they always say, oh, you'll be known as you're known in heaven. And in the same paragraph, the Bible says that when that which is perfect has come. And then it goes on, it says, I'll be known as I am known. So what is when that perfect has come? The kingdom of Jesus Christ, a thousand-year reigns of Christ. That's when is what is perfect has come. It's right there in the text. Go read it. Now I see through a glass darkly, but when that which is perfect it shall come. There won't be no more need for prophecy and all that when the Lord returns. Of course not. But in the church age, I'm not known as I am known because the Bible is finished written. Every Christian in the world don't know who I am. That's only when I get to heaven or when the Lord returns to earth in the millennial reign of Christ. Then everybody will know me and I will know all of them. So that which is perfect has not come. We're still living in a fallen world. I want to say this because I'm still going. I want to give you some wisdom. Common sense. If the people in the days of Jesus needed to see signs and wonders, Jesus said, if you don't believe me, believe for the very works that I do. Believe me for the very works that I do. Because, you know, this comes from God, the Father. So, if those people who lived in a day when there was, the doctors didn't know anything. I mean, there was no antibiotics, of course. Most of the people were poor, a whole lot worse than today. The average person lived to be 40 or whatever and all those kind of things. People didn't have nothing but to believe in God. So it was easier, just like in the Philippines compared to the U.S. or, you know, a first world country compared to a third world country. People in the nation of Israel in the world that day, it was much easier for them to believe to be healed because they didn't have a choice. If they didn't want to die, they had to believe for healing, because the doctors really couldn't do much for them at all. Now, in modern day, they got all kinds of medicine, especially in the U.S. You know, you could go there even without insurance. You go to the emergency room, they're still going to treat you. They don't turn you away. Philippines, they'll turn you away. If you don't pay, they turn you away. You don't get treated. You're going to just die at the door. They don't care about no Hippocratic oath and all that. Not here in the Philippines. You got to pay first. You're in there having a heart attack, and you got to pay to buy the medicine before they even give it to you. That's how crazy it is. And I'm sure that all these other third world countries are the same way. Now, those people, like here in the Philippines, they have a whole lot more reasons to take a chance and believe on the Lord. But people in the U.S., fat and happy with all this technology and money and all those things, they don't need to worry about God. They can just go to the doctor. That's why the church has got so lazy and out of faith. Well, we can just go to the doctor. Well, you know, no big deal. You know, God uses doctors too, which is true. But a lot of people are quick to do that before they turn to the Lord. So what I'm trying to tell you is that modern day people in first world countries need to see signs and wonders more than anybody, because they have more reasons. Atheism is an outspoken group today. They have more reasons to not believe in the Lord than any time in the history of man. With technology, as it says in Daniel chapter 12, in the end times people will run to and fro all over the world, and knowledge will explode, increase exponentially, which it has. Technology changes like that. People don't need God because they got, you know, they got virtual reality. You know, they got all, they can, you know, they're like the head of Google. Oh, we're going to live to be 500 years old. I'm going to put my brain on a hard drive and live forever. And that's just the beginning of what they're doing. I'll create a hybrid body. I'll make a clone of my body and put my brain in there, or whatever these people think they're going to do. Take the mark and live to be 500. All the things going to do. So how much more do people need to hear and see the miracles of God today than they did in the time of the Bible? People, you know, and these same old people have a form of godliness and deny the power of the... They say, well, we can read about it in the Bible. To the world, that's only a book. They don't even believe it's real. God as the I am is real. Not God as the I was to the non-believer is a fairy tale and a fantasy. But when they confront and encounter the God, the great I am right now, I am, not I was or going to be. Oh, when the tribute, there's some, a lot of these denominational people, like in the Left Behind books, after the rapture happens, then the gifts come back. You know, that great I was and the great I am, not today. You know, religion is what God did 1,000, 2,000 years ago and what God might do tomorrow, but not what God's doing today. God is the I am, not the I was or will be. I'm giving a whole nother message. People need to know the Lord as the I am the bread of life, not I was. I am the light of the world. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except by me. That's why they need the power of God, as I mentioned, 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 1 through 5, that their faith might not rest in the wisdom of man. Great talking, Paul says, great preaching, you know, to entice people, you know, Joel Osteen or whomever. But that their faith would rest in the power of God. In the power of God. In the power of His Holy Spirit. The gifts of the Spirit. The Spirit of God moving among people to get saved. Conviction. The move, the anointing of the Holy Spirit. No man comes to me, Jesus said, unless the Father draws him. That's why we need the power of the Holy Spirit. So every Christian watching this, you should desire to be baptized in the Holy Spirit. And you need to take all those doctrine, you know, your rose-colored glasses you're wearing, your doctrine-coated glasses off, and look at the Bible with the eyes of the Lord, with the eyes of your heart. You know, like that song, "Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory." Hallelujah. Praise His name. Ask God to take the blinders off your eyes and the wax out of your ears, that you might have an ear to hear what the Lord wants you to do. God has a call to action. You know, that's the problem with the internet. You know, it's a double-edged sword. You got, you know, people are eager, but lots of people on computers are sedentary people. They're shut-in people. God didn't call us to be a shut-in, but to get out there and be salt and light and move in the power of the Holy Spirit and be a witness to people. You can't do it without the power. If the disciples could have done it without the power, Jesus would not have said, "Tarry in Jerusalem until you shall receive power when the Holy Ghost has come on you, that you might be a witness for me." For here in Samaria and the othermost part of the world, Acts chapter 1, verse 8. You need to receive power from on high. I'm not going to debate with any denominational people about that. You don't want to receive the power of God? How, and I just always ask this question. How can people say they know Jesus, but they haven't run into the Holy Spirit? I can't figure it out. How do you know Jesus and don't know the Holy Spirit? You know, it's God. How did you get saved without an encounter with the Spirit of God? Or did you just have a mental assent and a mental agreement and you're a false convert? It's all in here that you believe in Jesus, not in here, in your spirit man. I caution you to buy from the Lord eye salve that you might put on your eyes, you Laodiceans, that you might see. Hallelujah. Clothes that's been washed and turned white by the blood of Jesus. Praise God. You think you're rich, but you're not. You're poor, blind, and naked, O Laodicean church. The lukewarm. Church of the lukewarm. The online group that we started is Church of the Firstborn. Most of the people I meet are Church of the Lukewarm. The Laodicean. The last church age. Praise God, brothers and sisters, I keep saying. I made videos on my channel if you search. 2 or 3 years ago, about how to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit and prayers to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. I know I said I would do it again. I need to. There's lots of people waiting on a word from the Lord, and I'm going to do that too as the Lord leads me. I got to do it as the Lord leads me. Not as people demand, but as the Lord would lead me to answer people who he wants to minister to through me, through those gifts. Gifts of word of wisdom and words of knowledge. And I will as the Lord leads me. God bless you guys.